of cuisine that can represents Trinidadian, Jamaican, Nigerian, and Creole. And you sprinkle in some of the diaspora and the American South, and there you have Kitchen Kit.
There have been Black people in kitchens forever,
mm-hmm.
And I would imagine if you walked into any restaurant, famous restaurant, not famous restaurant, there'll be a whole bunch of Black and brown people working in the back,
mm-hmm.
but not a lot of chefs. Why not?
Well, I think it's the same reason why there are not a lot of Black quarterbacks, you know? And if you go back 40, 50 years ago, they said that we didn't have the mental capacity to quarterback a team, and we're proving them wrong, and we need to continue to prove them wrong. But I think it's really, it comes from the top down, you know? It comes from editorial staff having more diverse writers, so they are more inclined to go out and seek out these young Black chefs or Black chefs in general. You know, it takes investors to put their cards in, you know, Black chefs' hands and let them have their shot. You know?
Do you see that as part of your role? If you're a very visible and successful
Absolutely.
Black chef, you can move the needle for other
Absolutely.
Black chefs?
You know, I think as chefs in general, we have a platform. We have to choose what we're gonna do. We can continue to put out great food, which is, you know, part of our job, but we also have another job to do, and that's to advocate for something, and that's what I'm here advocating for.
The book is called Notes from a Young Black Chef. It's excellent.
Thank
a
you.
Memoir at 27, 29 now. Pame from Lachi, nice to have you.
Thank you, Pame.
Yes, my pleasure.
When we come back, a roadmap for how one person can change the world.
Take the lessons from failure. They can be very powerful in terms of moving you forward.
Why tech pioneer Gene Kay says it's time for you to be fearless. Plus, how 3 million Americans could lose the ability to put food on the table.
Technology continues to change our world. Information now travels at the speed of light. Through all the innovation, there's been unintended and unexpected consequences. Fact is, our governor signed into law just recently a bill to abolish texting and driving. But why are we waiting until 2021? Just do it now. Think about your family. We, as a society, have become truly addicted to our screens and devices. We're raising our children in this scary new day. It's time to take a stand and reevaluate. Well, News, we think it's time to take some of the control back. We're going to help you sort through some of this together to manage the rapid change and keep our world and families safe. Too much of a good thing? This isn't good. Use technology and devices responsibly and reestablish limitations. 12 News will help connect you to solutions to manage it all.
Pretty intense monsoon storms move in.
A lot of rain in a short period of time.
You're getting the best live feed coverage tonight.
Everyone in this neighborhood seems to be okay. You're looking at live pictures right now from our storm tracker. It is just pouring here. People already dealing with damage from last night's storms.
We are firing on all cylinders this morning. The debris scattered throughout the street.
The most rainfall we have seen in more than 4 months. Still raining out there.
Social media and smartphones are contributing to an epidemic of stress-related disorders and antisocial behavior. Fact is, by definition, the word social is characterized by friendly companionship or relations. At 12 News, we think courtesy, kindness, and responsibility should be the standard. We promise to help advocate this behavior by connecting you with organizations and others who can relate. Please don't suffer in silence.
Promotional consideration for Matter of Fact provided by Consumer Cellular, where low rates and award-winning service are just the beginning.
Ordering takeout.
Finding the best route.
Talking for hours.
Planning for showers.
Do all the things you like to do with a wireless plan designed for you. Talk, text, and data for only $25 a month. Consumer Cellular. Go online or visit any Target.
You know the saying, go big or go home, and you know what that means. But do you know how to do it? Jean Case is the chairwoman of the National Geographic Society and the CEO of the Case Foundation. And for more than two decades, she and her husband, AOL founder Steve Case, have been investing in people who are changing the world. Her advice for reaching your goals? Be fearless. And it's the name of her book as well, which she recently joined me to talk about.
Nice to have you with us.
Thanks, Soledad. I've really been looking forward to this.
Thank you, me too. So, sometimes people who push back on being fearless will say, you know, actually, I need to be practical. I'm not rich. I'm not well-positioned yet. So, shouldn't I be practical first?
Yeah, it's a fair question, and I really should start out by saying, although the book is called Be Fearless, really what it's about is understanding fear will play a role in your life and pushing past it when you see it. Some people get caught up in this idea that it takes a special genius or some special quality that they don't have wealth or connections or the right school to take their idea forward. So about 6 years ago, the Case Foundation led some research to look at the core qualities of change makers and innovators and entrepreneurs. And what we found were really five simple principles that are present wherever transformational change takes place.
Let's walk through some of those principles. Sure. You lay them out kind of in chapters in the book. You say, take the big bet.
That's right.
And again, I think people are like, well, I would if I felt like I had a net underneath.
Yeah, right.
But I don't have a net, so I'm going to take the little bit, the
right.
Nice, safe little tiny step that I know I can do.
The great thing about all of the principles and really what the research revealed is it debunked the myth that you have to have some special quality. And the stories that are in the book, it really is a storytelling book to bring the principles to life. So the first story is Dr. Barbara Van Dalen, and she had an idea when we were at sort of the peak of the war and over 200,000 men and women were serving. Their families needed mental health support, but we didn't have the capacity in our administrations to serve them. So she started doing a pro bono hour, you know, an hour a week of where she would bring families in. She got friends to do it. Called me one day and asked me to come in, and she said, I want to build a national network of doctors. And, you know, looking at her, she was a sole practitioner. She didn't have an MBA. She hadn't done any work. She didn't even have an assistant. You know, she used an answering machine. And, you know, after I heard the passion and the conviction and the urgency she brought to the moment, I said, go for it. Well, not only did she got thousands and thousands of doctors from around the nation to join her. Her movement was called Give an Hour. And to date, they've done over $25 million in pro bono mental health care for military families.
Which is amazing.
Yes.
It really does add up those little steps. You say make failure matter.
Really, the point of the failure principle is to say, take the lessons from failure. They can be very powerful in terms of moving you forward and improving on your idea or what you're trying to get done.
I want to talk about unlikely partnerships.
Yeah.
I think often we gravitate to the people we know who are like us, who make us feel comfortable, who kind of think the same way because,
hey, that's comfortable, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that principle is called reach beyond your bubble. And the idea is, like it or not, we're all in a bubble. And so it actually takes, you know, intentionality to get out of that bubble. And how you do that is really try to surround yourself with people who think differently, have different backgrounds, different perspectives. There's overwhelming data, much of what of which I put in the book, that says diverse teams outperform non-diverse teams. This is true in companies. This is true in organizations. And so for those